What's up, guys? Kaiju Hunter here with Real Brothers Gaming. Today we are going to be capturing monsters. At this point in the game, I have reached about 100 hours into it. I have beaten the final boss, so to speak, but there's still so much more to do. I'm not trying to say I'm doing a completionist run, but you can get a lot of life out of it. Alright. I don't need any of that. The first monster we're going to go ahead and capture is a Yankudku. Or however you want to say it. After I kill some Kelpies. Still didn't get what I needed. Need that Kelby horn. Pathetic. Okay. This fight is not very difficult whatsoever. I mean, he's the second boss monster, really, that you have to fight. A good learning tool. Now, of course, you get more research points by capturing. It's easier to level up your research on the monster by capturing, and you unlock certain missions just by capturing. I believe it's also tied into obtaining the rainbow pigment armor. So once you reach high rank, you can change the pigment of your armor, basically any spectrum. But eventually, you get a rainbow pigment. And what that does is the color portions on your armor that can be colored will constantly change, flowing into each color, hence the rainbow. Once you fight a monster enough, you'll be able to actually see their keys and their tells. Generally, once you get so far in investigating a monster, it will actually show you skulls on their logo on the ground. Or your map, not the ground. And you'll be able to obtain, you know, exactly when they're gonna die, how far you can push them. Really not a difficult monster. I mean, anybody new to the series could easily beat something like this. Even on high rank, as long as your defense is solid. I would would say the biggest thing you have to watch out for with him is his jumping attack with the rock. That could easily cart somebody who's not ready for it. There he goes. Finished. Easy enough. That's one down. Wasn't too bad. Plus, because of the armor I'm wearing. Alright, so now we're heading after a Puke Puke. This one in particular is a bit of a challenge. It's a 15-minute match. So I gotta be on my A game for this. As long as I can find him fast enough, I can easily take him out. Scout flies already on him. And looks like Beetlejuice is in the map. This could pose a problem. I'm actually gonna drug up for this one. With a Beetlejuice on the map, this could get dangerous. Especially when I only have 15 minutes. I can lure him into the rock around that, make it faster. Oop. Always want to grab your footprints. Nothing's going to make life more easier. Nothing's going to make it easier than with footprints. Oh boy. There's Beetlejuice. Puke's this way. I'm being greedy. Come on. I don't have a whole lot of time. Yep, that's what I thought. If you could just leave, that would be great. Alright. It looks like lucky for me, Beetlejuice has already done some damage to him. Aw, come on. Let me have my greed. Puke is leaving? Yes, Puke is leaving. Bye, Beetlejuice. Not a whole lot of time for this. Come on now. invest in some beautiful gems. Now it's time for your tail. Not anymore. The PK fight really isn't too difficult, you just have to be prepared for that poison. And luckily for me, I have enough antidote gems to prevent poisoning completely. Have too much life left in him now. But we're not here to murder. We're here to capture, study, understand the monster, its habitations, why it exists. Some, you know, fast-paced mumbo jumbo garbage. I'm just here to leave a smackdown on it till it dies. But gain more knowledge about said creatures, it's easier to take them alive. Oh, come on. That don't. How about this? Make it nice and easy. Where is it? I hate that they're so far away from each other. Not too bad. The time limit always worries me. On to the next one. Maxed out. Alright, up next, the Barog. Pop some pills. According to this game, winners do drugs. Where are you taking me? Hold up, we got a friend. It's always nice to see another Palico in the wild. Ah, here we go. Let me grab it twice. If he he's in the right spot, we could cause more problems. Nah. Maybe he'll run to it. Alright, now that works perfectly, thank you. This fight's not terribly difficult, just really gotta watch out for the mud. He's going that way. That might cause more problems for ourselves. But for that bonus damage, just gotta get something that can shoot. We got it. There's gotta be rocks somewhere on the ground. Stones. Right here. Let's lure him into the center. Come on now. Follow me. Not here? Oh no, he's here. Come on. Do it. No. Oh, I guess it did work. Bye, Bara. Really? Ah, whatever. Might even get a turf war out of this one. Yeah, in case you didn't know, the bar it's a bit one-sided. Dude's got guts. You gotta give him that. Gotta respect a monster that takes on a bigger monster even though he knows it works. Did I get that part though? Oh, how did that? What even with the hitboxes? So I'll tell you, honestly, it's nowhere near as bad as the hitboxes used to be. You got no mud, buddy. Nothing left. Oh, I gotta watch out. Oh, man. Everybody needs to calm down. He's down. What's that pitfall? There we go. This takes forever to set up in comparison to the thunder trap. Don't screw it up.
Yep.
Perfect. Three and oh. Bunch of Garbo. Ah, but I got a gem. Excellent. Perfect. Well, that does it for this video. I'll see you guys next time.